Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out the new model I just designed. It's a simple to fold, simple to spin fidget spinner. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I used a 6-inch square of kami, but you could fold it from an ordinary sheet of printer paper cut square. Just make sure that it's 6 inches or it might be too big to fit your hand. Let's begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now let's rotate and fold in half in this direction. And unfold and rotate. And now we're going to make a crease mark right here. So let's bring this edge up so that it touches this edge, and don't fold all the way across. Just line it up and make the fold right at this corner. Like that. And unfold and rotate. And now fold this corner so that it touches this point, right where the crease mark touches the edge. Now we're going to fold the tippy tip behind. About like that. And now let's fold this flap so that this corner touches this corner. And once again, let's fold the tip behind. And rotate. And let's fold these flaps over this edge. Now, when you do this, make sure that this is very sharp. So make this come to a perfect point, and same on this side. These two points are what the model is going to spin on, so we want those to be as sharp as possible. Okay, now let's rotate, and let's fold this edge onto the long edge. And when you do that, try to hold down the layers so that they don't slide. And line up the edges, and once again, this should be a very sharp point. We're trying to sharpen it. And let's make the fold so that it goes from this corner to this crease. And unfold. And unfold. And let's repeat on this side. So hold these layers down and fold this edge up so that it aligns with this edge. And make the fold from this corner to the crease. And unfold, and unfold. Now let's make these two folds at the same time and pinch the middle fold. So all three folds get folded at the same time, and this flap sticks up. So this is a rabbit ear. And let's fold it up. And let's fold it down. Okay, now the idea of this model is that it's going to spin around like this. But we want these to be even sharper. So let's turn over, and we're going to make a rabbit ear at the tip of this flap. So just make an indentation with your fingernail. So we're bisecting this angle. And now you want to try to squeeze it in half. So it's like that. The important thing is that this is a point, a very sharp point. Okay, so it's like that. And now we're going to try to bend this point so that it sticks straight up. So hold on to it really tight and just bend it. So it's like that. And this point should point up so that it's 90 degrees to this surface, or maybe even a little bit further. Bend it a little bit more. If it's a little bit more, then when you let go, it'll be 90 degrees. So yeah, about like that. And now let's repeat on this side. So make the indentation. I'm gonna use my right hand. And squeeze the edges together like that. And now we're going to bend it up. So it's like that. I'm going to show you from different sides. And this still isn't 90 degrees, so I'm gonna try to bend it even more. Okay, that's pretty good. And bend this one a little bit more. Okay, looking good. All right, now let's fold these over like this. So we're squeezing this flap between the other two flaps. And bend them again in case they came undone. And just like this, it should work as a fidget spinner. You just hold it like this and spin it around. And you can also use your index finger like this. The trick is that you want to imagine that this is a ball on a string and you just swing it around and around. So you just want to move your hand, jiggle it at the right frequency so it goes around and around. Like that. Okay, now if you want to make it like a sphere, like this model, then you just need to bend these flaps. And just sculpt them to taste. That'll make it like a sphere. So it's like this. Oops. And it'll fly out of your fingers. It just takes practice to get it so that it stays in. And when you spin it, it's easiest if this point is directly over this point. So this plane right here is horizontal. That's the easiest position to spin it because you don't need to fight gravity. But you can also spin it like this. Isn't that cool? So there you have it. Okay, well, I hope you guys were able to fold that and able to spin it. And I hope you enjoy showing it to your friends. And you can challenge them to see if they can spin it. It's something that just takes practice. So, and these points will eventually dull and it'll be harder to spin. So then you'll just have to fold a new one. But there it is. All right, bye bye. But wait, before I go, I wanna show you this quick variation that I just came up with. It's a longhorn cow finger puppet and fidget spinner. And to end this video, here's a time lapse of me folding the longhorn cow. I don't think I'll do a tutorial for this, but if you guys really want me to, I might.